everybody. I've got a great easy fish recipe for you. So cooking it inside can be a bit odoriferous. So the best way to do it, cook it outside on a hot charcoal grill. It gives an amazing smoky flavor and you don't really stink up the house that way. I'm using striped bass today. That's right, striped bass. It's amazing stuff. And I have three simple ingredients. Well, four. But let me show you what they are. And then you can cook this in no time and have this on the table for your family in about 10 minutes. So let me show you what I have for the list of ingredients. Nice and easy. I've got the striped bass right here with the seasoned salt. It's going to stay like that for about 15 minutes to get room temperature and also marinating in the spices. Scallions. I have scallions over here. That's going to be chopped fine to put on top. And the last thing is we're going to drizzle it with a Japanese barbecue sauce. And that's it. Four ingredients. All right, let's put it on the fire. So I am using lump charcoal. Look at that. That's like a tree trunk. Now, it's usually cut in smaller pieces, but I just wanted to show you what lump charcoal looks like in the extreme. Here's the fish. We'll take one piece. We're going to put it on a piece of foil right here because there's the fire. Second piece here. Right there. Look at that beautiful fire. Now we're going to cover it up over here and make sure it's vented at about 100%. We're going to check that in about 10 minutes. All right, looks about ready. Let's check it. 145, 153. We'll take it. Let's take it off the fire. Come on in. Fresh off the grill. Check this out. Isn't that glorious? Oh, 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 striped bass. Okay, let's top it off with a few things. I always have fresh lemons on hand. I'm gonna slice a little wedge off there. You can do some for decoration in the plate as well. Let's do that. Some right in the plate. I can't have enough lemon, honestly, on my seafood over here because the flavors just go well together. They're just match made in heaven here. Whew, okay, let's squeeze a little bit on. I need another one of these here. All right. You want to put the liquids on first before you put on the pepper because it'll just make the pepper drain off. Let's put a little fresh cracked pepper. You know how I feel, fresh cracked pepper. Don't use the stuff that's already ground. That has very little flavor. It only has heat. The heat has gone, flavor's gone away. Now we're going to put a little bit of the scallion on there for a little color. Isn't that beautiful? All right, guys, let's try it. Oh, wait, but wait, there's more. A little bit of the Japanese steak sauce. Doesn't have to be a steak now, does it? All right, now we're gonna try it. Okay, striped bass from the hot charcoal grill. Now, this is not exact science to this because regulating the temperature is not like an oven. So you have to be a really good grill master, honestly. The internal temperature, you need one of those temperature gauges so that you can figure out what the meats are and not overcook them and have like fish jerky. So it's a play of so much charcoal and not having it over the charcoal or over the charcoal and how much venting for how much airflow. So you got to get used to it. But anyway, let's try the fruits of our labor. Oh, this is magnificent. I can tell already by the way that it's flaking. I love my seafood. And this is magnificent. Striped bass on a hot charcoal grill. It took about 15 minutes. So another easy weeknight meal. Just add some potatoes, rice, whatever you want. I don't care. Salad if you want to be healthy. Whatever. Anyway, Sante. Enjoy cooking in the kitchen with your family and your friends and make memories that will last a lifetime. Woo. Going in for more, guys. Yeah.